It is Monday, September 9, 2019. I am Farah Bates with tonight's edition of News in Depth. Welcome and thank you for joining us. In the headlines, 3-year-old killed in a road accident after running across the road. Here is Royston Drakes with the details.
The grandmother of the 3-year-old boy who was killed in a road accident at Islington Village, East Bank Babies, recounted the painful experience which unfolded before her eyes. The accident, which occurred last Friday afternoon in front of her business place, left Dominic Sokar dead. Speaking to this newscast, his grandmother, Ramwati Mohan, said the car was speeding.
My mother held the child hand, Dominic hand, while the other little child from Little Bethlehem and the one from St. Mary's, they did left. So, right then the bigger one run out of the car, my daughter Ben picking up the other one. So she didn't see from the car, she Ben picking up the child, the baby, while going a little bit. And she didn't see when he lose his grandmother hand, his great grandmother hand, and run over the road. But they all end up standing up at the edge of the road, and he was already at the other over of the road. And the car blazing coming, and they can't do anything. They try to tell the little child, don't come over, because they cannot run to him too, because they try to put their hand like this to let the car to stop, but the car paid no attention. The car didn't come in so speed. I believe he could have saved their life, because it's not nobody's fault. That child, my mother hold his hand till he reached in my shop. She didn't predict that he would have lose her hand and run over the road. And they all blaming my child. They all blaming my daughter. She's this and she's that and whatever. But we are the family, and we know when the kids are so little, you enjoy them. How will you want to lose a 3-year-old child when his smile is so beautiful? The words are so nice coming out of their mouth. They are not rude. When they grow big, they don't get rude.
Dominique was her first grandchild, and the woman said his death has left a void in her life.
It's very, very hard. He is a fourth grandson. He was the only grandson. He was the king. He was a little agitated, a little fidgety, but that's boy child. He wasn't a perfect kid, but he was a bright kid. He all don't know to count, he don't know to say ABC. He was now learned to say his name because his tongue didn't, pronounce the word properly. And 4 weeks to school, now he start grooving in, take a bath from his mother and walk in. 4 weeks to school. And now they took him away from us, and I can't even imagine that he's gone. It's so hard, I cry home, I got short today, and I couldn't even pray properly. Because me, I want to just keep running all the time. Pastor had to pray and said, God, I cannot send away a member from this church. How long you will fill them with your spirit that they could feel peace.
He was picked up in an unconscious state and was rushed to the New Amsterdam Hospital. He was later transferred to the Georgetown Public Hospital, but succumbed to his injuries before he got there.
More news after the break. Stay with us.
This is what shopping used to be.
More plastic bags than I could carry or I could use. They always end up in the bin or as unsightly litter. Then it hit me. Get just one reusable bag. Now, whenever I shop, I don't use plastic bags. I always have my reusable bag. It makes shopping a lot easier. And it's better for the environment.
Use one less disposable plastic bag. Make the switch to a reusable bag today. For more information, please call us on 226-2189 or 227-8429 or visit our website, moc.gov.gy. A message from the Ministry of Communities in collaboration with the Inter-American Development Bank.
Smart it! I mean, I'm telling you, but also loving yourself. Know what I mean? Value yourself, think highly yourself. Know you're very important. Hashtag, I'm a big deal.
VIP, me and my friend, I'm a VIP. VIP, ask anybody, boy.
I'm a big deal.
a big deal. Yeah, we're kind of important. For real.
All-in-one weapon for perfecting imperfections and capturing flawless skin. A lot of brands forget women of color or just don't understand that we come in all shades. From caramel to ebony, there's such a range. Iman Cosmetics is for every woman and features a line of skincare products and cosmetics including 16 foundation shades, powder, concealer, lipstick, blush, eyeshadow, highlighter, and BB cream. Visit us at Lot 75, Swamp Section, Rosal Town. That's behind the market. Or call 337-4422 or 688-9249. Shh.
Welcome back. Roger Khan anxious to come home, says his local attorney. More details in this report.
Self-confessed drug dealer Roger Khan's arrival in Guyana was delayed, and his attorney, Glenn Hanneman, feels it can take another 2 to 3 weeks. He said Khan is anxious to come home and is frustrated by the flight delay. Khan completed his 10-year jail sentence in a Miami jail and is expected to be deported to Guyana. Commissioner of Police Leslie James said, as far as he knows, Khan's delayed arrival was due to Hurricane Dorian in the region.
Of course, Mr. Khan's return has been made known to us, and we are awaiting his return.
Could you say when you guys...
I can't say when. I understand because of the hurricane that we've had in the Caribbean recently, his arrival was a bit delayed.
Can you tell us?
He said Khan will have no special treatment.
Khan, Mr. Khan, just like a normal person who returned under such circumstances. Nothing special about Mr. Khan.
Okay, would he be under any investigation while returning to Ghana?
I just said there's nothing special about Mr. Khan.
His lawyer would have said that he sent some letters to you. Have you responded to his lawyer, Mr. Hanneman, concerned? He's supposed to be representing him here.
Letters. Responded letters. I'm not sure the specific one you're speaking about. But letters which requires a response will get a response.
Khan, a confessed drug dealer, was allegedly linked to the Phantom Death Squad, which was said to be responsible for the killing of many Guyanese during the crime wave. It's unclear if he will be questioned by local police about his alleged involvement with the criminal gang. Back then, the confessed drug dealer took out a full-page ad in the newspapers, admitting to his role in the Phantom Death Squad.
All-in-one weapon for perfecting imperfections and capturing flawless skin. A lot of brands forget women of color or just don't understand that we come in all shades. From caramel to ebony, there's such a range. Iman Cosmetics is for every woman and features a line of skincare products and cosmetics including 16 foundation shades, powder, concealer, lipstick, blush, eyeshadow, highlighter, and BB cream. Visit us at Lot 75, Swamp Section, Rosal Town. That's behind the market. Or call 337-4422 or 688-9249. Shh.
I sell swaggerific. Spaniard me like staggerific. I Spaniard. When star give me a hand, the world place. Turn up. Stag in a me hands now. Hand up. Stag up. Tell them no. I do business if you're not on time. You must always have stag in the line. Well, everybody have a stag in the hand. Where's mine? Staggerman's beer.
Over 120 young people graduated on Saturday as the humanitarian mission Guyana Incorporated completed another successful skills training program. Some of the classes offered were information technology, cake decoration, sewing, and cosmetology. The classes ran for 6 months, and students were taught the basic skills in their respective fields. The mission's aim is to give young people the gift of education and skills they need to create better lives to escape the cycle of poverty.
Today, you acquired a skill. You planted a seed. Will that seed have a chance So, bro, think about it. Life does not happen to you. It happens for you. I will also say to the graduates, have no limits. Do not be contained. You are the container.
A representative from the Ministry of Education, Mr. Jai Prasad, offered words of encouragement to the graduating class of 2019. He highlighted the importance of education and work skills to press forward in achieving more in life. Officer in charge of Wim Police Station, Mr. Wayne DeHart, noted that knowledge is the key to lock the door of poverty. He told the graduates to utilize the knowledge they have attained to open new doors which will benefit them in the field of work, as education can change the world.
So, what you have to understand that the knowledge that you would have garnered over the period that you were training, you have to utilize it. And that is the only way doors will be opened. Because that key, the knowledge that you would have attained, it's in your hand, yes. It's in your head. But if you don't put it into play, then it's just a key.
With that, we've come to the end of tonight's newscast. If you have a news story or tip, you can contact us on 666-4337 or 654-0523. You can also visit our website at www.rdproductionjy.com or on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at Royce and Drake's Production for more details on these and other stories. Join us again tomorrow night for more news. I am Farah Bates. Good night.